Hey guys, so we're about a day away from the announcement of the Google Pixel 4 and 4 XL in New York. The Pixel 4 lineup has been the most leaked phone in history by both leakers and Google themselves. I'm Matthew with Cool Stuff, and this is going to be a different kind of video than the normal unboxing and review videos. This is what we know, along with what we think is possible during the Google Pixel announcement. So let's go through what we know so far. The Pixel 4 and 4 XL will not have a notch. The Pixel 3 got bombarded with memes and jokes about the massive notch, just like the Apple 11 Pro camera module has gotten so many jokes about how it looks like a stove. Well, Google has learned from its mistakes and will now go with no notch this time, but with more of a forehead. The reason for no notch? Well, there are several. Reason 1, Project Soli. Google has invested and has been working on Project Soli for a while, and because of that, we will have it in the new Pixel lineup. What is Project Soli? It is another way to interact with your device without touching it. It would be super beneficial to have it for a smartwatch where the watch screen is so small that swiping and tapping covers most of the screen, but to have it on a phone is pretty nice. Samsung and LG have played with this concept in the past. The most recent was LG's G8 ThinQ, which was released earlier this year, but many believe that it was very hit or miss and more of a gimmick rather than a super reliable feature. Hopefully Google has perfected it. There's videos out there that have shown it in action with apps such as Spotify, and even Google has leaked video with Project Soli. The second reason for the no notch would be for a more secure face unlock. With the renders, there seems to be no rear fingerprint scanner, and many believed that meant that there was going to be an in-display fingerprint scanner like in many flagship phones such as Samsung's Galaxy S and Note lineup this year, along with OnePlus's phones and Huawei's phones. However, it looks as if there will be no fingerprint scanner in any form, and instead Google has decided to go with the Apple approach with Face ID. Many phones have a face unlock feature, but it isn't as secure as Apple's. But it looks like Google's Face ID will rival that of Apple's when it comes to being secure, and looks like it may even work faster and be more smooth, but not having to do with the whole lean when the phone is on the table, so that'll be a cool thing. With the screen, it looks like there will be less of a chin. Kind of sad, because that doesn't give us room for a bottom front firing speaker like in the Pixel 3 and 3 XL, but instead a bottom firing speaker. I love the speakers on the 3 XL because many times when watching movies and videos, you tend to cover the bottom firing speaker with your hand, with the palm of your hand, or you have to either hold the phone in such a way that you don't cover it up or cup the speaker. With the 3 XL, I never have that problem and don't have to worry about that, and the speakers, in my opinion, were loud and great. The next thing, the camera. It looks like Google, along with Apple, will copy Huawei with a square camera module. Whereas Huawei placed the square in the center on the Mate 20 Pro, Apple, and it looks like Google in their leaks and renders, will place it in the top left corner. Google's camera has been one of the best, if not the best, camera in a smartphone for a couple years. Where many phones have two or even three camera lenses, Google has been able to compete with just one by using software. Well, it looks like Google has decided to add a second camera. I personally can't wait to see what Google can do with two cameras. The question is, what type of camera lens is it? Many believe that it's a telephoto lens, but there are a few out there that believe that it might be an ultra-wide lens. I would love to see an ultra-wide lens, but I'm not sure if that's what Google's gonna do. The next thing is colors. Google has historically had great names for their colors. Last year, the Pixel 3 and 3 XL had three colors: just black, clearly white, and not pink, even though it was clearly pink. This year it looks like there may be more: just black, clearly white, maybe pink, slightly green, sky blue, really yellow, and oh so orange. These colors haven't been confirmed, but it's safe to say at least the just black and clearly white and the oh so orange would be there, especially since the leaks show the oh so orange. I personally love the color of the oh so orange, so we'll have to see. When I first got the Pixel 3 XL, I had issues with RAM management, and it looks like at launch, Google's phones had the same issue. part of that was software, which Google has updated, and the phone is smoother now, but part of it is, in my opinion, was the amount of RAM. Many phones at the time started at 6 or 8 or even 10 gigabytes of RAM, but Google last year decided to stick to just 4 gigabytes, which many questioned why only 4. I know Apple sticks with 4 gigabytes of RAM, but they also couple that with the most powerful in-house processor in the business. Well, this year it looks like Google will at least add 2 more gigabytes to make it 6 gigabytes of RAM to somewhat future-proof the Google Pixel 4 and 4 XL. However, I wish they would make maybe double it and do like 4 more, so that way it's like 8 gigabytes to kind of be on par with the competitors such as Samsung, Huawei, and even like OnePlus. Finally, the price of the Pixel 4 and 4 XL have been leaked by Best Buy Canada. It looks like this year's Pixel phones will be more expensive, which is understandable due to the Project Soli and Face ID hardware. However, it looks like it may cost more than Samsung and Apple phones. The leak shows that the Pixel 4 will start at $1,049 Canadian dollars, and which is about 820 euros or about 902 US dollars, and then go up from there. The Pixel 4 XL will start at $1,359 Canadian dollars, which is about 1,128 euros or about 1,239 US dollars. There have been other leaks that show that the Pixel 4 XL will start at 999 US dollars, so it's not really confirmed how much it will be, but it does look like it will be more expensive than the last year's Pixel 3 and 3 XL. Of course, prices may change based on currency fluctuations. Outside of the Pixel 4 and 4 XL, it looks like Google may announce a 5G version of the Pixel, as well as a new Nest Mini speaker system, the Pixel Watch, and possibly new Pixel Buds, and finally a new 13.3-inch touchscreen laptop called the Pixel Book Go. We don't have to wait long to see what Google unveils now. The announcement will be at 9 a.m. in New York on Tuesday, October 15th. This has been what we know and believe will be the Google Pixel 4 and 4 XL. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more, go ahead and subscribe. Hit that bell icon to be notified when I upload a video. And until then, see ya!